Today I'm going to teach you Strings of Heart from my book Lush and Blooms, page 14. I have already painted some of these hearts last night and this morning, and right now I'm just going to show you the paints that I have used. Okay, I'm using Winsor & Newton. For the darker colors, oxide of chromium. Another color is Terry Verte. And there's some other colors that I have used is Van Gogh Permanent Green. And I have them prepared on my palette. Of course, with some other colors like the maroon. Yeah. And Sienna that I will prepare them, and I have all the colors mixed with water. Yeah, so I have like a leaf green also. Yeah, some of the basic colors that I need. So I just will show you a few more leaves that I've been painting. Okay, first of all, you have to wet it with a layer of light green. The paper I'm using is Archer's 300 gram hot press paper, so it's smooth, and a bit of this brown. Yeah. When you're painting this, you really need to be very neat, in a sense that if you have like in this sense, I have drew it beforehand. So okay, when you apply the water, it has to be within the pencil line. Yeah, so this is the texture on this leaf, and let's wait for it to dry while I paint another one just next to it. Hope it's visible. So I let this kind of dry on its own for a while. So when it kind of dry, it looks quite different. Yeah, it looks quite different. And so maybe I show you how I paint the veins using the bit of the brown here. With some different colors. So I hold my brush a little bit more upright. Mix a little bit. So if you want the veins to kind of drop down, this to add on. And okay, over here, just checking if you can see me. Just add on. Okay, so this one, it kind of have quite a nice texture now. So I just add on a little bit brown. Yep. And okay, inside here, okay, the leaves has to be darker. But sometimes if you refer to the photo, when I was painting this, I was actually looking at from a photo. So dark green. Just to show that it's behind. But I have kind of different texture there also, like different green to make it look more interesting. This color is a little bit strong here. So I mix it again. Yeah, alright. So I have two more, a few more here and I miss up. Still. Yeah, sometimes I hold my brush a bit lower to give cover more area. Yeah, so this is the pearline green that is very dark. I know, I think it's oxide. Okay, let me check. Yeah, it's pearline green, the darker color. Yeah, this one. Oh, there is a bit. Okay, my hand touches it. In this case, I think I will just add in a thyme leaves to cover it. Because I didn't want to show the it's dirty, so I add on. I add on the small leaves there, so it dry up, and you see the texture here. Okay, now I need to be a little bit more careful because over here is dry already, so I'm. Yeah, so if I want it to be slightly brighter, I can add on a bit of colors. Again, these colors is a little bit too strong, so I dilute it a bit. And okay, I'm over here now. Ah, I'm left with a few tiny ones only. So I can have a bit of just because the leaves are the smaller one, I have it lighter in color. So I use a lot of water for my lighter leaves. Strings of heart, so I kind of string it up. And okay, the last few leaves to finish up before I show you the whole piece. I hope I can. I can still add on a bit of darker green. Yeah, so I'm left with two more. Just put a plant. Okay, this one the not so good, so I add on again one more time. You see, I can add on some more colors. Okay, this one I'm going to. Okay, there's one more here. getting the shape correct. So you see I diluted a lot and now it's very light, very very light, just like this one. I have a bit of green and I add in a bit of brown, and when it's dry it looks that way, close to that. This one I still can change a little bit. And okay, this is the piece that I have done, and I did miss out some hearts. Okay, some hearts, one over here. All right, my hand keep touching that. Okay, one more heart to go. So it's really hard, one heart at a time. You have to paint it. Yeah, it requires lots of patience. Because every heart, you work on a wet onto wet technique. And you just add on different colors. And of course, the important part is about drawing the whole piece. The whole piece like this. Refer to my book again, Lush and Blooms, and page 14 you will see this one was done as a A4 piece, but right now I'm working on is a A3 piece. Yep. So I hope you learned something today. Thank you.